There was no one that could cry a song like she could. There was no one that could make you feel the emotion.
Crazy for feeling so blue.
To me, she was the greatest voice of that era.
These records hit me so hard. Something about Patsy Cline for a woman in the 50s was very progressive.
Patsy Cline, you can put shoulder to shoulder with Ella Fitzgerald and Frank Sinatra.
I never met another woman that could out-sing her.
She sells millions of records every year. It's unbelievable how many records she sells.
Patsy didn't just knock the door down, she kicked it in.
Got a feeling 'cause I'm blue. Oh Lord, since my baby said goodbye.
Patsy was a fighter, feisty, forthright, and funny. You had to be to break through in 50s Nashville. At the Grand Ole Opry, Temple of Country Music, Patsy scared the life out of newcomers.
One night, I was changing clothes, and that door popped open, and it was Patsy. And she had on this cowgirl outfit. And she stood there with her hands on her hips. She said, well, you're a conceited little so-and-so. You just waltz in here and do your bit and waltz out. And I said, now wait just a damn minute. And we just almost had it right there. And she laughed. She said, anybody that'll stand up to the Cline is okay. So we're going to be good friends.
Patsy Cline, isn't she great?
You know, she was a good-looking, rough, rugged, one of the singingest people I've ever met. She would cuss you out just as quick as somebody else. And if you didn't like it, you know, you knew where the door was, and she'd tell you that.
Yeah, she could hold her own with a crew of sailors.
Patsy was born in 1932, in the depths of the Depression. There are reports of her being sexually abused by her father. It was a troubled childhood.
It was like she preferred not to go there, and I didn't ask.
When she was 14, her father left the family. Patsy dropped out of school to work as a waitress and a singer.
She's our special guest tonight from Virginia, and her name is Patsy Cline.
Patsy Cline, how are you, Patsy? Nice to see you. And the bell rings with me now, Ernest. This is a young lady you've
In the 1950s, Nashville was very, very conservative, even more conservative than most of the nation.
Women singers rarely headlined shows, and the industry assumed that women wouldn't buy their records.
The breakthrough of Patsy Cline was really a watershed moment.
We have a young lady that is fast becoming one of the leading sellers on phonograph recordings, Miss Patsy Cline.
I've loved and lost again. Oh, what a crazy world we're living in.
Patsy was just breaking into the music business when she met her second husband.
I asked Patsy to dance, and she said she couldn't while she was working. Later on, I seen her dancing with somebody else, so I went back and I said, you said you couldn't dance. She said, that was my husband. But then one week, she showed up and her husband wasn't there. So I went back and asked her to dance again, and she did, and that was that.
They both had a temper. He said one time, if I hadn't taken up for myself, she'd have killed me with a baseball bat.
I seen her knock the hell out of him with an iron one time. They'd have a little fight, and she would call, and the police would come out and arrest him.
They're just two crazy people having fun.
I go out walking after midnight.
Patsy was always on the road, always working.
Oh, I remember very much missing her when she'd have to leave. Kids cry and have fits, and I do remember that. I do remember that we weren't just waving by. It was very hard. I think that was probably one of the things that she really didn't enjoy about the business.
Now come on in and sit right down and make yourself at home.
Patsy came up the ranks singing good old hillbilly country, but now her producer, Owen Bradley, was pushing her towards pop.
From what I understand from Owen, she really saw herself as a hillbilly. She didn't want to sing pop songs.
She said, I've always done Western swing and it's kept food on my table. I said, Patsy, honey, you listen to Owen. I said, you've got the talent, but he's got the ear, and he knows exactly what the market needs.
The Weeping Ballads won. This was something quite new, a sophisticated country pop sound.
She had this huge heartache voice, and they chose heartache lyrics for her because she could just about weep in tune. And then they would take and cushion the sound of her records with strings and made it a softer edged country music.
Patsy made quite a lot of records that were quite elegantly arranged and they didn't sound so country.
Patsy was taking country music into the city. She'd made the music modern. Her look was changing too, from cowgirl outfits to cocktail dresses. I Fall to Pieces was a country and pop hit. She might not have liked the song much, but she liked it being a hit.
She had no money, old car, and they were going to repossess her refrigerator. And she said, well, hoss, they ain't going to get my frigidaire now.
Do you ever cut anything but hits?
Well, I don't know if I can help it.
Oh, my. Prove it, girl. Prove it.
All right. Crazy. I'm crazy for feeling so lonely.
Crazy, the number one jukebox hit of all time, cemented her crossover appeal. It's become her signature tune.
All Patsy Cline has to do is kind of just barely whisper crazy, and it's like, oh, not everything's moonlight and roses and falling in love for the first time with Prince Charming. Sometimes, you know, love is really horrible and it makes you feel like you're going mad.
Why do I let myself worry? Wondering what in the world did I do? Oh, crazy.
There was so much soul and life to her voice. She lived all the songs she was singing, heartache and love.
All the pain and trouble in Patsy's life came through when she sang these songs.
I'm crazy for trying, and crazy for crying, and I'm crazy for loving you.
It was all inside, and she let it out in those songs. It was there for you to hear.
Great singers have some gift. You gotta believe that they've been crazy or that they have fallen to pieces or they've lived these songs.
And crazy for crying, and I'm crazy for loving you.
On the way back from a performance in Kansas City in March 1963, Patsy was killed in a plane crash. She was only 30.
I remember Dad waking me up to tell me that she wasn't going to come home. It's something you don't really understand at 4 years old, I don't think.
Sweet Dreams was released after her death.
Some of the songs are kind of sad. They have a lot of emotion in them. And I do like to listen to them to kind of feel close and to kind of to see what she was like. It helps you to remember a lot about them.
Instead of having sweet dreams of